Welcome to my small terrace garden. I am going to explain all the caring tips of vinca or periwinkle. Yes, I am talking about hybrid varieties here. Now let's know how to grow them and how to get blooms throughout the year while I am planting some new members of this family today. One thumb rule is where whenever you buy any plants, don't be in a hurry to plant them in a fresh potting soil mix the same day. Keep them as it is at least 1 week to be used to your place and the environment. Second rule is, whenever you root them into the soil, always remove 1/3 of the old soil carefully. Don't damage the root ball and don't destroy the thin fibrous side roots. Now let's know about the soil. Vinca thrive in a well-drained acidic soil. I usually use this soil mix, plain garden soil 2-part, vermicompost 2-part, river sand 1-part. You can add perlite also and add fungicides and neem powder. Don't use cocopeat here because it retains moisture. Let's know about watering. Root rotting is very common, so don't overwater them. It is also drought tolerant, so it can tolerate underwatering to some extent. But for better growth and flowerings, it needs first moderate regular watering, just enough to soak the soil only. And second is, avoid watering on the top of this plant more frequently. Vinca does not need any hard pruning, so don't cut any healthy branches of periwinkle during blooming period. And to make it bushy and not getting to be leggy, just pinch or remove new growths at the tip of the branches. For good air circulation, don't plant them too closely and cut some lower branches to thin out the plant time to time. Vinca are not heavy feeders, so don't over-fertilize them. Apply micronutrients or vermicompost once in a month or any homemade organic liquid fertilizer twice in a month. Don't apply any chemical fertilizer. So let's talk about some common diseases. Sometimes you notice the sudden dying of your healthy plants, that is because of root rotting. It mostly happens in rainy season due to overwatering. Overwatering always leads to fungal infection in the root systems. The symptoms are, you notice dark brown to blackish color, mossy stems and the yellowish leaves. So to get rid of this problem, you have to cut the infected parts, apply fungicides and water them when the topsoil is dry. And second, to get rid of fungal infection, remove the dead leaves, dead branches regularly and always make the surface around the plant clean. And to avoid any pest or insect attack, apply this homemade pesticides. Now I am going to place my new members proper location in my garden. I know vinca loves bright direct sunlight for at least 3 to 4 hours daily. Even they can tolerate 6 to 7 hours direct sunlight. Even they can tolerate some partial shade also. But remember, once your plants get established at a particular location in your garden, try not to change their spot. This is all about how I care my vinca or periwinkle.